Alright, we're at part 2 in our video series, More Problems That Contain Percentages, or More Equations That Contain Percentages. We're going to define equations very quickly. An equation is identified by the equal sign. Now, as this term shows, an equation is an expression showing two quantities are equal. These two quantities make a true statement. Now let's very quickly define percentage. Percentage is a part or a portion of 100. A percentage is represented by the percent sign here. Okay, let's look at another example. What percent of 300 is 60? Now we put in our formula as we did in the last video. We have percent over 100 equals is over of. Now the first thing to do, as we learned in the other video, is to plug in what we already know. Now here we have of 300. Now here we're going to replace of with 300. Next, we have is, and it's right next to the 60. So we're going to replace is with 60 in our formula. Next, so since there's no value to plug in for the percent right here in the formula, we're going to put an X there, and that's going to be our unknown that we're going to solve for. Now that we've plugged everything into our formula, we're going to cross multiply to solve for the unknown. This diagram will show exactly how we're going to do that. Now we're going to start with the X. We're going to multiply that into the 300. We're going to put our equal signs in there. We're going to go with 100 and multiply that into the 60. Okay, here's the new equation that we're going to be working with. Now, before we move on, we're going to very quickly multiply 100 into 60 and go ahead and get 6,000. Go ahead and simplify that. Now we're going to move on to our next step. Okay, here's our new equation. You can see how it's constantly changing. Now we're getting ready to move into our third step. Our third step, what we're going to do is we're going to get X by itself. Now, if you remember from the other videos, the way we did that was by using a reverse operation. And to refresh your memory, a reverse operation, pretty much if you add something, then subtraction is the reverse operation. If you multiply something, then division is the reverse operation. Let me show you how that works. We have the equation again. What we're going to do is we're going to divide 300 to get X by itself. Now, as you remember with an equation, there are two equal terms. So the equation means that the terms are balanced. So whatever you do to one side of the equation, you're going to have to do to the other side to make sure the terms stay balanced. So since we're going to divide 300 to get X by itself, we're going to have to also divide 300 by the other side. Again, what you do to one side, you're going to have to do to the other to keep the equation balanced. The left side of the equation cancels out. Now we have X by itself, and we very simply, we're going to have to divide 300 into 6,000. Now we have our final answer. We've gotten X by itself, and we've simplified the other side. So now the equation is balanced, and we have our solution. All right, 20% is our solution. Now we go back and look at our original problem, because we were looking for a percent. What percent of 300 is 60? So now we know 20% of 300 is 60. Now let's check our answer. X equals 20. What we're going to do is we're going to plug the solution back into the original problem to see if the equation stays balanced, thus making sure it's correct. We have our original equation. We're going to plug 20 in for x, or where the percent is. Now we're going to very quickly again cross multiply. Now we have this new equation. We're going to simplify both sides. 100 times 60 is 6,000. Now for the right side, 20 times 300 is 6,000 also. So that's a true statement. 6,000 does equal 6,000. And again, the equation is balanced, so the solution worked. That's the end of the second video. Thank you.